morning, children. Now we are in the general science class. So we have finished three chapters, that is nutrition in plants, nutrition in animals, fiber to fabric, and now the next chapter is heat. Okay, now what we have studied in the last class, we have studied about the animal fibers, isn't it, in the fiber to fabric. So in that we have studied about wool and silk, isn't it? So now we are going to study about the heat. So plant fibers, so from where we get the cotton clothes, we get from the plant fibers, and woolen we are getting from the animal fibers. So now what type of clothes do you wear in summer? In summer we wear cotton clothes, isn't it? When we feel very hot, what type of clothes do you wear? You wear the cotton clothes. Why do you wear cotton clothes? Because it keeps you cool, isn't it? You don't feel hot in the cotton clothes. And when you feel very cold, what do? When you go out of the house, or when you are inside the house also, but still you feel cold, isn't it? So what you do? You wear the woolen clothes, isn't it? That is the sweater, socks and all. So in this way you cover your body. So we wear different types of clothes according to the seasons. In the summer season we wear cotton clothes, and in the winter season we wear the woolen clothes. So cotton is obtained from the plant fibers, and woolen is obtained from the animal fibers, that is from the sheep, and plant from the cotton plant. Okay, then now we see, now your body knows, you feel hot and cold, isn't it? Now how to find an object is hot or cold? Now you take a piece of chalk or this book, anything, can you tell is it hot or cold? No. So unless and until you touch anything and sense, and immediately you remove when it is too hot, and when it is too cold also you feel that it is cold. So now how to find an object is hot or cold? So in our daily life activities we come across so many hot and cold objects, isn't it? So that will decide which object is hot and which object is cold. So by touching them. Now early morning you drink hot milk or hot tea. What do? Do you drink directly? You will see it is very hot. You keep it for some time. So you feel the hotness. When you touch, you will know it is hot. Now ice cream you eat. When you tell ice cream what it is, it is cold. So like this, hot and cold you can identify. Now here in the book you have the distinct table. What all things we come across in our daily life, hot and cold, that you have to mark it. I'll read it out, you can tell me. So here in our daily life we come across a number of objects. Some of them are hot and some are cold. So tea is hot, I told you, ice is cold. So like that, few objects are given here. Now ice cream, is it hot or cold? If you already have been in the class, the cream, isn't it cold, isn't it, like that. Then spoon in a teacup. Will it be hot? Yeah. The lower part will be hot, not the upper one. Little warm it will be. Then fruit juice, that is also cold. Cool, not so cold, maybe cool also. Some will drink too cold, some will drink the cool only. Then handle of a frying pan. When you fry or when you make the dosa and all, you have seen the handle, will it be hot or cold? When this thing pan is hot, not the handle, because it will be made up of wood and all. So little bit you can see it, but not much as the pan, isn't it? So like this, few objects are given. So you can write other than this also. Milk you can take, it is hot. Sometimes some people keep the milk in the fridge, make it cool, and then they drink. They don't drink the hot milk also. Like that, so many things are there what we come across in our daily life. So by touching we can make it out which is hot and which is cold. So now there is another activity, what you have to do it. So what you have to do it, you have to take three vessels and name it as A, B and C. So in the first one you have to take hot water, in the second you have to take cold water, and in the third one you have to take the mixed water, that is hot and cold water. Okay, so if this activity is on the smart board, I'll show you, explain it through that. Okay, otherwise you can do it at home and see this activity also.
and cold. In this module, you will learn about temperature, a measure of hotness or coldness of an object. In everyday life, we come across many objects that are either hot or cold. A cup of tea or coffee, an ice cream, and a bottle of cold drink are some examples. Some of the objects might be hotter than others, and we decide which objects are hotter by simply touching them. But is our sense of touch reliable? To understand this, let us do an activity. Take three large mugs A, B, and C. Put cold water in mug A, hot water in mug B. Ensure that the water is not too hot, and a mixture of hot and cold water in mug C. Now dip your right hand in mug A and your left hand in mug B. After a while, put both hands simultaneously in mug C. What do you feel?
So this experiment you can do at home and see, but don't take too hot water, okay? Not too cold water. The water should be little bit of cold, little bit of hot. And put both the hands and tell me how do you feel? So the right hand in the cold water, left hand in the hot water, isn't it? So how do you feel both when you put it in the mixture of hot and cold? One hand you feel hot and one hand you will feel cold.
The water in mug C feels hot to your right hand and cold to your left hand. Interesting, isn't it?
So where you have put in the cold water, that hand when you put in the mixture of cold and hot, you will feel again cold only. And hot, you will feel hot.
Now you can understand why we cannot always rely on our sense of touch to decide whether an object is hot or cold. Then how can we know how hot an object really is? We can know exactly how hot an object is by measuring its temperature. And to measure temperature, we use an instrument called a thermometer.
So to measure the hotness of an object, what we use, or temperature, we'll measure with the temperature. You see the temperature, according to that, temperature is measured by the instrument known as thermometer. Now you see, whenever sometimes your body, you feel too hot, when you touch your forehead and all, you see that it is hot. So now you will know, you will feel whether you have a fever or what. So what should we immediately take the thermometer. Nowadays everyone has a thermometer in your home. Because of this COVID, we are keeping everything at home, isn't it? So your mother or you yourself can take the thermometer and check the temperature. And even in the school, now as the schools were started for Vidyagama last year in the month of January, every day we were checking the temperature of each child with the help of thermometer. So all are familiar with the instrument called as thermometer, that is the digital thermometer. Just they can see it on your forehead or on the hand also. There also they will tell you how much is the temperature of your body.
In this module you have learned, we can decide if an object is hotter than another by simply touching it. However, our sense of touch is not reliable. To know exactly how hot an object is, we need to measure its temperature. Temperature is a measure of the hotness or coldness of an object.
So like this you will have have the definitions in your lesson. At the end, keywords are there. No, there you will have what is temperature. So when you listen to the class, you can write even these definitions also. Temperature is a measure of hotness or coldness of an object. Then what is temperature? To know exactly how an object is, we need to measure its temperature. Now you see here, what is heat? Heat is a form of energy. In our daily life, we come across a number of objects such as ice cream, tea, cold drink and so on. So some of them are hot and some of them are cold. Already I have discussed with you, just now we have done the table also. Completed the table. So this is hot and this is cold here. So some objects are hotter than the others. By simply touching the objects, we decide which is hotter than the other. Our sense of touch is not always a reliable measure to degree of hotness or coldness of an object. A reliable measure of the hotness of an object is its temperature, which is measured by a device called as thermometer. So temperature is the degree of hotness or the coldness of a body. So this is about hot and cold. We have studied about the introduction of the lesson. How to find an object is hot or the object is cold. Now just now we said temperature is a degree of hotness and coldness. Now how to measure this temperature? What is the instrument used to measure the temperature? Now let us see that. Now to see the temperature, we have two types. We have a thermometer, an instrument which is used to measure the temperature, that is called as thermometer. In thermometer also you have two types of thermometers. One is clinical thermometer and another one is, one more you have, lab thermometer. So these are the two types of thermometer, laboratory thermometer. Clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. Clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of the human beings, human body. And clinical thermometer, other than human beings, other objects. For example, water, like that. So now let us study about first the clinical thermometer. So already you are familiar with the thermometer, how to use the thermometer, working of the thermometer. So now let us read about clinical thermometer.
Clinical thermometer. In this module, you will learn about a clinical thermometer.
So can you see here? This is a clinical thermometer. Here you will have two scales. One is Celsius and another one is Fahrenheit. So this is 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, then 40, 41, 42. So this is called as a Celsius and this is called as a Fahrenheit. So here you have 95, 96, 97, 98. So here you will have the difference of 10 units. And here you will have a difference of only 5 units. In the scale also you have the 1 centimeter. In between you have 10 lines you will have between the lines. So like that, here 35, 36, 37, you have a difference of how many lines? 10
clinical lines. Thermometer. In this module, you will learn about a clinical thermometer.
And in the Fahrenheit, you will have only the 5 lines difference. Can you see here 95, after that 96 you have. In between you have only 4 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. So here you can see this thermometer very clearly. This is a clinical thermometer. This is measured in Celsius as well as in Fahrenheit. These are the two scales. But in India, we use only Celsius scale.
Your forehead feels warm. You immediately suspect a fever. To be sure, however, you need to measure your exact body temperature. How would you do that? Well, with the help of a clinical thermometer, also called a doctor's thermometer.
So this clinical thermometer is also known as doctor's thermometer. So you can see how it is kept inverted.
A clinical thermometer is usually made of glass and consists of a mercury-filled bulb inside at one of its ends and a fine capillary tube that looks like a thread running from the bulb to its other end. There is a small constriction in the neck close to the bulb.
So what are the parts we have seen? Critical thermometer is made up of glass, isn't it? And it has a capillary tube and it has a small constriction. This is called as the constriction. Like this you will have a part. This is called as the small constriction.
A clinical thermometer can measure temperature ranging from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius or 95 degrees Fahrenheit to 108 degrees Fahrenheit. That's a pretty small range. You can get the temperature by reading the scale inscribed on the side of the thermometer. Let us now see how a clinical thermometer works.
So here, this is how the scale is measured from 35 to 42 degrees Celsius. Now we will see how the working of the clinical thermometer is done.
A clinical thermometer is usually placed inside the mouth for measuring body temperature. Because of the body heat, the mercury inside the bulb heats up, expands, and rises to a certain level in the capillary tube through the constriction. The new level to which the mercury rises indicates the exact body temperature. You may be wondering if the reading changes on removing the thermometer from the mouth. Well, it does not.
So how you have to keep this part of the thermometer under your tongue? It is not necessary you have to keep under the tongue. You can keep it near the knee also. Here also they keep it and they keep it for 1 minute and then they can measure the temperature. Even on the forehead, you can keep and measure the hotness of your body.
The constriction prevents the mercury from flowing back into the bulb. You can also say that the mercury column breaks at the constriction and is unable to return to the bulb, thus remaining stationary in the tube. To reset the thermometer, you need to swing it sharply many times so as to make the mercury column return to the bulb. Why do you think mercury is used in a clinical thermometer?
So, when you remove this thing from your mouth, the thermometer, the level, the temperature does not change because mercury will be there, which will prevent it from going back into the bulb. So, why this mercury is used in the clinical thermometer? Let us study about it.
Mercury is used in a clinical thermometer as well as other thermometers for a number of reasons. First, mercury is a metal and thus it is a good conductor of heat. It starts to expand instantly on placing the thermometer inside the mouth. The expansion can be seen as a rising thread of mercury. Second, mercury remains a liquid at temperatures ranging from minus 39 degrees Celsius to 357 degrees Celsius. Hence, it can serve to measure a wide range of temperatures. At last, mercury does not stick to glass.
So these are why mercury is used in the thermometer. The reasons for this, there are a number of reasons. The first reason is mercury is a metal and thus it is a good conductor of heat. The next one is mercury is very sensitive to expansion. Mercury remains a liquid at a temperature ranging from minus 39 degrees the last one is mercury does not stick to the glass. So only whenever the thermometer breaks, we can see the mercury falling down.
Though using mercury thermometers has advantages, mercury-based thermometers are considered risky. This is because mercury is poisonous. In case the bulb or the neck of a thermometer breaks, mercury can leak out into the mouth. This is why mercury-based clinical thermometers have largely been replaced nowadays with electronic digital thermometers or scanner thermometers.
So this type you might have seen in the school, isn't it? Pions also understand the thermometer measuring the temperature. So mercury-based clinical thermometers have been nowadays placed with the electronic digital thermometer or scanner thermometers. So nowadays they are not using the old thermometers. Why? If supposing thermometer the glass breaks, mercury will go into your mouth and that is very poisonous. So because of that,
that a clinical thermometer is a thermometer used for measuring body temperature. It is usually made of glass and consists of a mercury-filled bulb at one of its ends and a fine tube running from the bulb to the other end. The neck near the bulb has a small constriction. A clinical thermometer can measure a very small range of temperature ranging from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius or 95 degrees Fahrenheit to 108 degrees Fahrenheit. When a clinical thermometer is placed inside the mouth, the body heat causes the mercury in the bulb to heat up, expand and runs up the capillary tube through the constriction up to a certain level. The new mercury level indicates the exact body temperature. Mercury is used in thermometers because it is a good conductor of heat and expands uniformly. It can be used to measure a wide range of temperatures and it does not stick to the glass. Mercury-based clinical thermometers have largely been replaced nowadays with electronic digital thermometers or scanner thermometers.
So now this is about clinical thermometer what we have studied. Now how to measure the temperature?
Measuring temperature. In this module, you will learn the temperature of a body using a thermometer. Thermometer is a device used to measure temperature. In this activity, you will learn how a thermometer is used to measure the temperature of a body. In order to perform this activity, we require a lab thermometer, a brick piece, brick powder, beaker, and water.
So these are the things what we require to do the activity, that is lab thermometer. So lab thermometer, I said there are two types of thermometer. One is clinical thermometer, another one is lab thermometer. So lab thermometer is different from clinical. Lab is used for measuring the other objects, not the human brain's temperature. Okay. Then brick piece, brick powder, beaker and water. So this is lab thermometer, not the clinical thermometer. We have studied clinical thermometer readings, how it works and all. Now let us study, do this activity and I will tell you about the lab thermometer.
thermometer and laboratory thermometer. In this module, you between a clinical thermometer and a laboratory thermometer.
First, we study about the laboratory thermometer. Then only we do the activity. So you should know what is a laboratory thermometer. Already you have studied about clinical. Now let us see about the laboratory thermometer. So what is the difference between clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer?
A clinical thermometer has a slightly different structure from a laboratory thermometer. Their methods of usage are also different. Let us learn the difference between them by performing an activity. For this activity, the items required are a clinical thermometer, a lab thermometer, water, and a beaker. First, let us measure the temperature of the liquid using the lab thermometer. Immerse the thermometer in the liquid without touching the bottom or the walls of the container. Also, the thermometer should be kept upright. See the mercury level indicating the temperature. If the thermometer is taken out, then the mercury level will be changed. Therefore, keep the thermometer bulb inside the liquid until the reading is taken.
So what you have to do, you have to keep the clinical thermometer in the liquid till the readings are taken. Otherwise, there will be change in the reading.
A laboratory thermometer cannot be used to measure the correct body temperature. A clinical thermometer is used for this purpose. Usually, the bulb of the thermometer is kept under the tongue for 1 minute. The thermometer is not kept upright. Also, reading is not taken when the bulb is under the tongue. The thermometer is taken out and then the reading is noted. How is it possible? Have a close look at the clinical thermometer. There is a kink near the bulb. It prevents mercury level from falling on its own. Before using the thermometer again, one has to give a few jerks so that the mercury level falls to the initial position. This is the difference between a lab thermometer and a clinical thermometer. In addition, ranges of temperature measured using the two thermometers are different. The lab thermometer usually measures the temperature between temperature of ice and that of steam, that is, between 0 and 100 degrees. Clinical thermometer is designed for measuring human body temperature that ranges between 35 and 42 degrees.
So here what we have studied, clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of the human body. Whereas clinical thermometer is used to measure the lab or the water, the temperature of the water and all. And the clinical thermometer have a connect, it will prevent the mercury falling down. So here in the laboratory thermometer, you don't have the mercury. In the laboratory thermometer, 0 to 100.
In this module, you have learnt a lab thermometer cannot be used to measure body temperature. A specially designed thermometer called clinical thermometer is used to measure human body temperature. The lab thermometer usually measures the temperatures between 0 and 100 degrees Celsius. Clinical thermometer measures temperature that ranges between 35 and 42 degrees Celsius.
So, a laboratory thermometer cannot be used to measure the body temperature. A specially designed thermometer called the clinical thermometer is used to measure the human body temperature. The laboratory thermometer usually measures the temperature between 0 to 100 degrees Celsius. Clinical thermometer measures the temperature that ranges between 35 to 40 degrees Celsius. So here there is a question is asked to you, what is the difference between clinical and a laboratory thermometer? So you have to make two columns and then write. You must write the first difference is a laboratory thermometer cannot be used to measure the body temperature. This is the first point. Then a specially designed thermometer or clinical thermometer is used to measure the human body temperature. This is the main difference between clinical and the laboratory thermometer. The second one is temperature. Here the laboratory thermometer, the temperature ranges between 0 to 100 degrees Celsius, whereas in clinical thermometer it ranges between 35 to 42 degrees Celsius. So this is the difference between clinical thermometer and the laboratory thermometer. So today what all we have studied? We have studied about how to find an object is hot and cold. Then we have done the table, we have sorted out which objects are hot and which objects are cold. Then we have done the activity, that is how reliable it is to rely on our senses. That is, we have done the activity by taking the three types of water, that is hot water, cold water and the mixture of hot and cold. And from that activity we have said that we cannot rely on our senses. So the measure of the hotness of an object can be measured by its temperature. So to measure this temperature, you have a special type of instrument or a this thing is measured by a special type of instrument that is called as thermometer. So we have seen how thermometer is used and the types of thermometer. There are two types of thermometer. One is clinical thermometer and another one is lab thermometer, laboratory thermometer. And we have studied about difference between laboratory thermometer and the clinical thermometer. So today we'll stop here. The remaining lesson will be continued in the next lesson, next class. So please take down the notes, read the lesson. Very soon you will be having the FA1 test also. Be prepared for it. Okay, thank you.